Hello, I'm Calm Cal, welcome to another video. In this one we're going to look at exchanging an M.2 format drive to an NVMe drive. This is my son's computer. We're doing various updates on this one and mine. So there are various different versions of the M.2 format, going from the 2230 up to the 2280. The most common I've come across is the 2280 size, which is 8 centimeters, and you can see at the top there's versions of NVMe, which has just got the one indentation from the top right hand corner, and then the SATA is pretty recognisable because it's got two slots missing, the B and also the M key. Nothing to do with a supermarket. When you do things like this, just make sure that the power is unplugged from the back, and also what I like to do as well is press the power button a few times, just to disperse any energy or voltage that might be contained on the motherboard. I also like to leave them a couple of minutes just to make sure. There's a little bit of dodgy software on this drive that my son's been using, so what I'm going to do is just unplug the other hard drive, the one he hasn't been using. This is the one he's supposed to be putting games on. I'm just going to unplug this while I just put a new version of Windows 10 Professional on here. So I just tuck the wire underneath it out of the way, and then what we're going to do is just replace the drive completely with this new NVMe drive, which was featured in the previous video. When you do think of installing an M.2 drive or an NVMe drive which will fit in the same slot, just make sure the NVMe drive is compatible. And also what you have to worry about is I've got integrated graphics on here. I'm thinking about upgrading it soon, but that means that I'm going to have to install a graphics card. The graphics card always goes into the top slot. This is a similar slot, but this one's always the fastest one. So you've got to be thinking that when you install a graphics card, it's going to be sitting on top of your M.2 drive or your NVMe drive. And if you've seen my previous video, the Crucial MX500 SATA drive or M.2 drive, you'll understand that I was worried about the temperatures with this one. It's just something to think about, the temperatures.
Some M.2 slots are away from this port, but it just depends on your motherboard. So when you attempt this, use a magnetic screwdriver, because you don't want the little screws falling in inside of the PC. It's a lot harder to take out. As you take the screw out, you do notice that it does spring like a springboard, and this is normal. Just give the SSD card just a little wiggle from left to right. You don't have to force it at all, it'll just pull out on its own. As you can see, here's the difference between the SATA and NVMe format. So you can normally tell with an NVMe drive because it's just got the one slot missing from the top. And you can see they are both the same size. One's got one notch and this one's got two. So when inserting it, try and do it at this angle and then just give it a slight wiggle backwards and forwards as you apply a little bit of pressure. Notice the springboard action, and this is normal. So you just fix it with the little screw here. Don't over tighten it, because there's no pressure on it, there's hardly any weight to this. It's just to keep it in place, that's all. So just make sure it's in reasonably snug. And there we are, all installed. So we just need to put Windows on here and use this as our main boot drive. There's going to be more videos to come on PCs, just as I'm doing upgrades. Bear with me, I do bounce backwards and forwards on subjects. Don't forget to like and subscribe. My name's Cal, have a good morning, afternoon or good evening. Farewell till next time, and I will see you later. Thanks for watching.